Hello engineers, have you ever thought about engineering drawing? Sometimes we call it as manufacturing or production drawing as well. Do you have any idea about what are the things required to be mentioned in the engineering drawing or manufacturing drawing? Because when you release a manufacturing drawing to the production department, being a design engineer, it communicates your idea about the product and it communicates everything you want to. So what are the things required to be mentioned in the engineering drawing? It is necessary to know. Let's have a look at what are the things required when we create engineering drawing. Starting with the history of engineering drawing. The history of engineering drawing or drafting, it goes back to 2000 BC when a fossilized plan was found showing an aerial view of Babylonian fort. This is what the fort was, and there was a plan found. So this engineering drawing thing is not new to us. You can see it is since 2000 BC or before that. Then let's talk about the drafting. What exactly drafting is? So drafting actually uses a strict set of standards and rules. You must be aware about ANSI standards, ISO standards, JIS standards. These are the standards as well as rules which are actually defined by ASME, like which we use. So when a technical picture is created on the drawing board or on CAD, it can be universally understood. When you create a technical drawing, when you create an engineering drawing, manufacturing drawing or production drawing, or you can call it as drafting, it should be universally understood. Otherwise what will happen? I can understand a particular language better. I will create that drawing in my language using my own standards and symbols, and I will send it to someone else. What will happen? The same person will not be able to understand the drawing because it was created by me as per my own standard and my own understanding. Then the person will create the drawing in his standards as per his own understanding. He will send it to me. Definitely I will not be able to understand that. So to make this unique, to make the drawing universally understood, there are some strict sets of standards and rules which are actually defined by the standards. Like when we call ASME standards, what exactly it is? It is the standards and rules. ISO standard, yes, these are the rules, these are the standards which are actually universally understood, known to everyone. It is the language of communication for us. A designer communicates the idea, concept and facts so that the other manufacturers, fabricators, they can understand it. How they communicate? They communicate by means of your engineering drawing or drafting. No designer will go to the manufacturer, no designer will go to the inspection team and tell how to do this. What he or she will do, he or she will actually mention the things in the drawing by means of those standards, by means of symbols. If those standards and those symbols are not known to the concerned person, then there is a problem. Similarly, these things should also be known to us. Now, what exactly drafting or drawing is? So, 2D drafting or drawing is simply a language of communication between the designer and the user. The designer, the design engineer will communicate his idea to the users. Users can be inspection engineer, he or she can be production engineer, process engineer, assembly engineer, and many more who actually has to read the drawing for their work. Then 2D representation of 3D model having details regarding views, sections, cutouts, dimensions, and annotations. So engineering drawing or drafting is also a 2D representation of a 3D model, because we cannot create 3D models, so we have 2D representations of that. Isometric view is actually a 2D representation of 3D. Similarly, we create other views so that we can show each and everything required. That's why we prepare engineering drawing. Drafting needs to be followed by some standards. Some standards as per ASME, as per ISO, whichever standard you follow, doesn't matter. Standards like projection method you have to follow, sheet sizes you have to follow, some common symbols are there. You will have to follow those things. Then drafting or engineering drawing, it must be self-explanatory and must not create any type of confusion regarding any details. When you release a drawing, then it means you have communicated everything. The concerned person should not come to you and ask what exactly it is or how to do this. Similarly, you should not go to the concerned person and tell this is how this thing is required to be done, or that's why this thing is mentioned. The drawing, the drafting, it should explain itself, because the current scenario in the industries is a bit different. You create your drawings in some other country and you manufacture your product in some other country. If you are in the same plant, then yes, this particular thing is possible that you communicate with the concerned person. But now there is a case of countries. How you will be able to maintain the communication? So whatever it is, it should be mentioned in the drawing or drafting. What exactly drafting is? Just have a look at the 3D model. This is what a 3D model is, and this is what the drafting is. So 3D, I cannot represent it properly, so I have created some views. On the views, I have given all the dimensions, annotations, symbols, everything, and by this drawing or drafting, I am able to explain the manufacturing process, inspection process, assembly process if required, everything. This is what drafting or drawing is. Then the most important question comes, what are the things required to be mentioned when you create a drafting or drawing? If I'll ask you to create a drawing, what will you decide first? What will be your first selection? Say, this is what the drawing is. Can you tell what are the things required to be decided or selected first? And again, this is not the question about creating it using any of the CAD tool. It can be using paper pen as well. We will be discussing that sequence. First, we will decide the sheet size. What should be the sheet size when you prepare a drawing or drafting? That is most important. Whatever standard you are following doesn't matter. Whatever unit system you are following, we have sheet sizes available in those units as well. You can see the sheet size or paper sizes from 4A0 to A10. These are available in mm as well as in inches. Select the standard and select the sheet size first. Then you will be defining, you will be going to create the title block, where your name of the organization for which you are creating, your name, who has actually drawn, the inspector name who will be checking it, the part name, projection method, scale and material of the part which for which you are creating the drafting will be mentioned. All these things are must. Projection method, yes, it is must. Scale, yes, it is must. Material, it is also must. If you will not mention the organization name, one way it can be accepted, but if you have not mentioned the material or projection method, it will be rejected. Then you will be deciding the views for your reading. Do you have any idea about types of views? When anyone asks us what are the types of views, then a simple answer comes: front view, side view, top view, left hand side view, right hand side view, bottom view. No, these are not types of views. These are actually orthographic views. Within orthographic, you have front view, you have top view, you have left hand side, right hand side, bottom. All these views are available. When I'll ask about types of views, then you have orthographic views, you have isometric views, you have sectional views where you show the internal cutouts and internal features, auxiliary views where you show your features which are available at certain angle, then detailed views if some small portions, small sections are there which are required to be highlighted, then you prepare the detailed views over there. Continuing the requirements, next comes annotations. In annotations, there will be dimensions with or without tolerances, GD&T symbols which we will use, notes with or without leader, tables if required, then symbols like machining symbol, symbols like surface finish symbol, welding symbols, it can be custom symbols as well, which a particular organization decide and which are actually understood to the organization only, so that if a drawing by mistake leaks, there is a very less chance for copy. The other organization or person will not be able to copy that, because we have our own custom symbol, we have our own custom language of communication which is actually understood to us only. This is what we have. Similarly, if we talk about the assembly drawing, then we will need to place the sub-assemblies, we will need to place the exploded view as shown. We will also need to place bill of material as well as balloons, so that each and every part in the assembly or sub-assembly is identified and assembled at the right place. This was all about the engineering drawing, the things required when we start preparing engineering drawing. The sequence is actually most important whenever you prepare an engineering drawing. whether it is using any software or using paper pen or using the another method, the sequence will somehow be same and it will be important to us. Thank you.